Hello and welcome back all of my dear students. So today we are going to start our new chapter, that is Stone Age and Stone Tools. So in this video we are going to learn about what are the different types of tools that were used in our ancient ages. Okay, when the human settlement was not there and there were no kind of means to do agriculture and all those things. Now, how did humans use their skill to make certain tools, and why did they made different kind of tools? That is what we are going to learn today. So first of all, we will learn about what is Stone Age, then what are tools, what are the different kind of need of tools, and again we will see how did we went from living in caves to settlement of the villages. So this all took a lot of years, like thousands of years have been passed in doing all these different things. So we will look at certain things, like how did tools impacted on the life of human. So let's get started. So let us first understand what is a tool and what is the purpose of different kind of tools. Why do we use such a large variety of different tools? So first of all, I will like to give you an example. Let's say there is a shiny object that we want and it is buried inside the ground. So what do you think we would do to take it out? So first of all, we will try to scrape the soil and then we will try to bring that thing out with our fingers. But what if this doesn't work? Then we will try to take it out with a stick. Okay, we will take something for our help and we will try to then scrape this soil out. Again, if this also doesn't work, we will have to look at a different tool to use this. Now we will take a stone, a pointed stone instead of a stick. If the soil is hard, then we will do such thing. Again, if this also doesn't work, then we will take a rod, okay, an iron rod, and then we will try to dig it with this. Again, if it doesn't work with the iron rod, we will use a new tool that is used for digging. So this shows that we need to choose the tool according to the demand of a task. Particular task we have to perform and we have to use a type of tool for that. So now there are a few factors that determine our choice of tools. So first is availability of resources. Like if we want to use a tool, it must be present around us only. So whatever it is around us, we will make tools out of it and then we will use that thing. Then second is the minimum use of time and energy. Like if we want to make a tool, it should also take less time for us to prepare that tool. Then again, maximum efficiency. We have to consider into mind that whatever tool we are making, it should give us maximum efficiency. And then the skill of handling tools, which is acquired through practice. Now, one more thing that is important is that whatever tool we are using, it should be also skillfully handled by us. And how do we get to improve our skills in using this tools is through practice. So I hope you have heard, practice makes man perfect. So that thing goes here. Now you see, there are different kinds of tool that I just told you that we use for different purpose. Like if we have to tight a screw, we will use a screwdriver. If we have to cut an onion, we will use a knife. If we have to kill a certain insect,
we will use different kind of things. Like we will not use a spear to kill a insect. Okay, we will use a spear to kill an animal that is entering inside our home, which is dangerous for us. Like we don't kill anyone for no reason. So that is the thing that we have to understand. Now what happened is that today, as we are learning about Stone Age and the tools that were developed in the Stone Age.
Now let's talk about certain uses of tools. Like let's say if I want to go for hunting. Now what kind of tools will I take with me? Will I take a spoon? Or will I take a bucket with me? Or will I take a dish and I will go to hunt? No, of course not. I will need a spear, a knife, or a bow and arrow to go into the forest, and then I will use that particular tools to hunt down an animal. So you see, the tools have different purpose, and we have to use different kind of tools for different set of tasks that we have to perform. So right now we will discuss about what different kind of tools that we have found that our Stone Age man was using in that ages.
So you see, man had developed the tools with continuous and minute observation and experimentation and using their imagination also. And you see, humans learn to sharpen the tools for some purpose. Like they got to understand that we have to sharpen a tool in order to use the tool effectively. Now why Stone Age is called as the World Stone Age? So here we say Stone Age because this is the period or the age in which the tools, maximum tools that were used by humans, are found to be made up of stones. So that is why we call it as Stone Age. Now this Stone Age is again divided into further three types, that is Old Stone Age, Middle Stone Age, and New Stone Age. Now again, the name for this Old, Middle, and New are like Paleolithic Age for Old Stone Age, then Mesolithic Age for Middle Stone Age, and Neolithic Age for New Stone Age. Now here, Lithic, the word Lithic means stone, and Paleo means old, Meso means middle, and Neo means new. So it goes like this: Paleolithic, Mesolithic, and Neolithic. Old, middle, and new. So you know, in the previous chapter we have studied about Homo habilis and Homo erectus. Now these Homo habilis and Homo erectus are called to be of Old Stone Age. Okay, Old Stone Age. Now both of them made the tools by using percussion method. Now what is this percussion method? It is the technique that involves beating or striking one large object on another object. Like you see, we try to sharpen an object. Like if we take one big stone and then we take another small stone and then we strike both of them, but what do? We strike the bigger one on the smaller one to sharpen that smaller stone. So that method is called as percussion technique. Now these tools were made in Old Stone Age, and these were very raw type of tools. Like you see, these were not used for different kind of, or like the use of these tools was not much. They were only used for particular one thing. So they were used to chop certain things, like chopping the flesh of animal, then scraping out the meat and separating it from the skin of the animals. Then again, they were using some heavy stones to throw at animals, small animals, not big animals. So by using these things, they made this certain tools for different purpose. Now you see what happened. The Homo habilis had less knowledge of the tools, but as the time passed, the Homo erectus made good tools by sharpening them. Then again came our Homo Neanderthalensis. Our Homo Neanderthalensis, I hope you remember, this man was found in Germany, and the Neanderthal name is of that city where we found the bones of this man. Now you see, Neanderthal man was big, heavy, and he was very muscular man. Why? Because this Homo erectus man developed a tool that could hunt big animals. Okay, by using these tools, the humans, Homo erectus humans, were able to hunt animals, and due to that thing, they used more meat in their diet. So what happened? The size of the man grew due to the inculcation of this meat in their diet. So that is why we see that erectus was a little bit small and Neanderthal looked like very muscular bodybuilder and big man. So this is all due to the development of tools and the techniques of these things. So the main hunt was made of deer, again bison and rabbit. Like, these animals are not much harmful for humans, so that is why. Now remember, till this date about Neanderthal man, we were not able to hunt wild animals, big and wild animals, because we had less tools. Now what happened? Then comes our Homo sapien. So sapien is what? Intelligent man. So this Homo sapien developed the tools of like spear and knife. Okay, big spears, knives, again axe, and all these different things. Now this allowed this Homo sapien to hunt down big animals. Like, they used to hunt elephants, then wild boars. Again, different kind of animals which were threat, they used to kill them for food, of course. So what happened is that by now we used we have developed a lot of tools that could be used for hunting, then again building fire, then again scraping out meat for different purpose. Like, if you want to make clothes, let's say. Clothes that day, in those ages, were not made up of cotton and fiber. They used leather or skin of the animal to wear around themselves. So they used choppers and scrapers to separate the skin from the meat. So you see, these are the different types of the tools that we have seen through these ages, various ages.
So I hope you got to understand that what kind of tools that were used in that particular age by the Stone Age man. And you see, you have to always remember about why the tools are used, what is the purpose of using a particular set of tool, and you see, how do we make that tools. Like, you see, we have to always look for the availability of that resource that we are using to make certain tools. Then when we want to make a tool, it should be very easy to build that particular tool. Again, if we want to make a tool, we should see that it is again very efficiently made with a lot less effort. Again, if we want to make a tool, we have to also see that the tool which we are making is of high quality and it is made with good resources or good materials, and the efficiency of work of that tool should be more, and we have to learn the usage of tool and how to use that particular tool for a particular task. We have to practice that thing a lot. So while making a tool, we don't have to make something which is very hard to use. So that is what we should keep in mind. So that's all for today, and I hope you got to understand something about how the Stone Age people were using to live their life, and how was their lifestyle in that particular age, and what types of tools they used in that age. That's all for today's video, and we will meet in our next video.